eyes on me. Buffalo G. Special episodes for you today. This is For The Views 2.5. My name is K Shane, Teddy Bear Shane, Smoke Face the Visionary, and the man to my left is...
I already know what it is, man. It's your man, Mark J, also known as AF47. Now, that stands for the Unty Fucker. For the Bunker. For the Bunker. 47. See, that's the range that I fuck him in. You hear no thing.
And the man to my right is...
Yes, sir. You know what it is, boy. AJ, man. I'm taking it. I'm just going to get at your boy.
Now, this is a very, very, very important episode because, you know, not recently, but a while back ago, somebody who passed away, unfortunately, way too early due to another man's hands, we lost a very focal point, big focal point in the black community, and his name was Nipsey Hussle. And now today, the verdict came out that basically his killer will be doing life in prison. Now, how do you guys feel about that?
I feel like you can't call it life if that nigga's only gonna last one day. It's not really life.
No, man, my thing is, I refuse to believe he was in the hole for fucking 3 years, but it's possible, you know what I'm saying? Well, they let this nigga make it to court to get sentenced.
Well, I mean, because they have to.
They have to isolate him.
So he was in the hole for the 3 years.
Isolation.
4 years.
And that's crazy, the fact that, like, this happened basically 4 years ago, because it really feel like it was just yesterday.
And I think what's so crazy is, like, if you look at it, you almost don't think he was in isolation because that nigga had black eyes. He got his ass whooped while he was in there still. That's what's so crazy. Like,
but I'm pretty sure there's some guards in there that fucked with Nip too.
Yeah. I think it's crazy. Did y'all hear what the judge said?
I heard what the person said in the stands, but I did not hear what the judge said.
No, the judge is literal, like...
He's got a green light by all the gangs.
Yeah, he's been green light by every gang in prison. When the judge tells you, like, yeah, nigga, it's probably over for you, big dog.
It's a done deal. Don't worry about it. By the way, Coca-Cola, you don't sponsor us, but you will one day. Now, the thing of the matter is,
Pepsi.
Huh?
I hate Pepsi.
Yeah, that's right.
I got a story about that.
Yeah, we hate Pepsi around here. We don't do no Pepsi products in this.
You got a story about Pepsi?
Yeah, I'm very curious. Like, I was trying to ignore it, but, like, we'll get to that. let me put some hot honey jack down your ass while I fucking sip out a little cold thing of Pepsi.
I don't want to know what this Pepsi is. I actually know. I wanted to know. I kind of do too. No, man. It's not. It's
a long story. It's not what we're talking about.
Stay tuned for episode 3 when we talk about Mark J.
Exactly. Stay tuned, guys. When we start talking about Mark J. And his pet thing, we're going to call it Pepsi. Did he do it or didn't he? Like, because I want to know what's going on. We ain't going to talk about it right now.
Did you save up a bunch of bottle caps and they never gave you your fighter jet? Is that what happened?
Hey, you know what? They made a documentary about that shit. I forgot what small country it was they did some shit in, and Pepsi got, like, sued for millions, like, billions of dollars.
That's true.
But the thing is, with Nipsey Hussle, we think and feel like, has gang culture changed in today's day and age?
It's definitely different from what it was, from, like, even from, like, when we were kids to what we see now, from what our parents saw. Like, it's definitely changed a lot, I feel. And I feel like the fact that Nipsey Hussle was killed in his own neighborhood, in front of his own store, on his block, by somebody who was supposed to be affiliated with the same gang, kind of just goes to show, like, how much that shit's changed, you know what I mean? Because there was a time where, like, nigga, the cops wouldn't even need to come get this nigga. Like, he would have been dealt with.
Like, bro,
he would have been on the spot.
There's been people, remember that chick, I don't know how long ago it was, but it was within the last 3 years. That chick, somebody killed her brother, and she killed him within, like, 24 hours.
Yeah.
And then text her brother's phone talking about some, I got you, bro. Like, that's crazy.
Yeah.
So the fact that nobody has had access to this man in this time, that's kind of wild.
It makes you wonder, definitely. I would say, if anything, like when you're thinking about the culture, like you also gotta look at it like this. There was a point, like for example, Chicago's a great example. Mm-hmm. Chicago really took a left turn when they took all the OGs off the street. Because there was no more leadership.
There was no more leadership, and all of the major gangs started to turn into small factions. Exactly. And those small factions turned into even smaller factions.
And they all beefing with each other.
All in, mind you, yes, you got people who got little cousins that your two cousins is at war with each other over some blocks that ain't even theirs.
And, well, that's like a rapper, I forgot who it was, he said that. He was like, my cousin was affiliated with this gang, I'm with this gang. I would never be the nigga to pull the trigger on my own cousin, but I couldn't tell somebody else not to.
Exactly, that's kind of wild, because it's like, that's your family, that's your people, and you resonate more with a nigga that's in a gang with you versus your actual blood.
Yeah, like he showed up to the funeral, like still, you know, repping his hood and everything, and it's like, nigga, like, this shit was literally over gang, like, your cousin just got killed by somebody from your hood, and like, you out here repping your hood at your cousin's funeral, like, that's tough. Like, you know what I mean? Like, your grandma looking at y'all like, why, basically? Like, what the fuck is going on?
Now, Mark, you have told us you were a former Crip, so...
Bang your set real thing, you know what I'm saying?
Like, can we do that shit? No, I'm just playing, man.
Yeah.
Hoover, cuz. Hold on. Let's get a cheer for the crowd, man. Bang it out for Hoover Crips, Hoover Crips, Hoover Crips.
For
Hoover.
No, this is what I see, man.
By the way, Hoover Crips, don't come after any of us.
Unless y'all want to sponsor us.
Unless you want to sponsor us. Hey, just remember the disclaimer at the beginning of the episode. These are jokes, baby.
These are all jokes.
All jokes, my God.
Don't drink Pepsi.
So, is that why you don't drink Pepsi? Was this some Hoover shit?
Was it some Hoover shit?
No.
Okay.
It's about to get deep.
It's crazy guy could have tied in. But anyway, that's how I feel about it. Man, when people say, hey, yeah, man, it was a time where they had leadership and everything. I wasn't born during that time.
That's
what I'm saying. So, like, we can only say what we hear. But it was also a lot more violent. They didn't have the access to the fucking drums and sticks that we
have. Oh, about the switches and yeah. What are the kids calling nowadays? Oh, I got that dick on me. That's crazy. Yo,
when
that's
that happened,
wild.
I officially knew I was old. I seen that shit on Facebook a couple years ago. I was like, yo, we called them shits ratchets and fucking
drums. No, that's true.
And these we called call them dicks and what the what?
I remember one time this nigga was like, yeah, bro, I got the AR with the monkey nuts. And I was like, the what?
He's talking about the two drums.
I was like, huh?
I'm okay with that one though.
I can live with that one though.
That shit like might sound hard in the song, but the niggas was just talking about some, I'm driving around with the two dicks. Like, that's crazy. That's crazy. He's talking about his own dick in a fucking extended clip that allegedly looks
see,
like
this. This is why, I'm gonna be honest with you, I fucks with music. Fucks with a hard body, and I fuck with the new music, but listen, I would rather hear, when it's about sex rap, I just rather hear bitches talk about it. That's why everybody be like, my pussy's so good, I hate this shit, I'm taking the headphones off. No, I love that shit, because that's
you
what I want to hear.
You might be the first nigga that's actually admitted that shit out loud.
I like the music videos.
Oh, the music videos be fire. The video with Glorilla and Cardi B?
Oh.
That's only, I don't understand. I love me as a hood bitch. Just something about Glorilla. She do it for me.
Man, I'm just telling you like this, though. I don't want to hear no fucking thought out bars from no female rappers. I just want to hear about fucking.
Touche. Actually, but that raises a good point now that we're talking about gang culture. I feel like that's something that's also evolved in gang culture.
Female?
Women used to not really be in it like this, but nah. Like,
it depends on the state. Especially I feel like, and it depends on the state and the ethnicity. Because I feel like Hispanic culture, from what I've seen, from what I've been told from my mom who's lived in California when she was young, from family members, and seeing it in Chicago, like Hispanic culture, females really be with the shit.
Yeah, Yeah.
Nothing wrong. Yeah. Black people be with the shit, but they be on some like real pretty shit. I ain't seen some like back at the crib, you know, I ain't trying to say nothing, but I see some females blow some shit down that just happened to be Hispanic.
I mean, yeah, but at the same time, bro, I'm telling you, like, you got to, like, I just, like you said, they was always down the rod and everything, but at the end of the day, it was always the men who was really putting in most of that work. Nowadays, it's like, women got their own gangs down there, like, they,
man, now, I will agree with that, I was looking at some shit on YouTube the other day, and if I can find it, I'll pull it up. It's some, like, real live female gangs. There was a female gang in Alaska, which is crazy, because it's Alaska.
Alaska.
Don't worry, we'll talk about it. Let me find it. I got you.
That's wild.
I will flip this screen around and
I don't even know what I would do if I was in Alaska.
Like, niggas, it's too cold to be over here worrying about y'all. Need to be worried about fishing and the fact the sun ain't going down for 30 days. Like, what you...
I'm not here for it. Like, we can't do this, baby.
That shit wild. How you feel about female gang culture?
Honestly, I think it was always around, but it was just always attached to the male culture.
But you say it was female. So you would say they played a different role back then as well.
Yeah, I'm saying, what do you think?
I mean, honestly, man, I'm going to be real with you. The majority of the girls I see in gangs, they were just affiliated because a nigga was in the gang.
Okay, and I'm completely in agreement with that. Mm-hmm. I've met so many females, oh, I'm bomb, G, and I'm over here, bitch. This nigga start blowing this bitch. You are out of here.
I'm gonna turn around. You got me out here with
this. Exactly, like, you are out of here. I'm not trying to hear that shit.
Well, that was also the thing, too, though, like you said, like, it was because that niggas was feeling it. It's like, just because you taking GD dick, you know what I mean? You a GD bitch.
You can't tell it with that.
Like, hold on now.
Look
at your camera angle, AJ. Let's say that again.
Just because you was taking GD dick, don't mean you a GD bitch.
Okay? The more you know. Okay?
I'm going to be honest with you. Now, when you talk about gang culture from then and now, I think it's all different because y'all niggas is from the Midwest. I'm from the East Coast. And it's totally different gangs on the West Coast. Or similar games, but everybody does shit differently. So I don't know what y'all grew up seeing.
Was y'all like color banging and shit?
I feel like y'all.
I mean, everybody color banging. It's not everybody.
Chicago, we know the colors, but we don't actually bang on a nigga.
Don't y'all hat bang?
No.
That's
what we hear, nigga. I never been to Chicago.
It wasn't so much like.
It was the direction.
Exactly.
It was the direction of which you went.
No, no, I mean.
It's like how niggas with bandanas left or right, the hat, the way you put your hat on, basically, niggas.
It had to, because, you know, Chicago niggas understand, like, it's about your flavor. Like, niggas, like, we like to dress nice all the time. We gotta look good, just chilling type shit. So it's like.
Niggas be step, you know how to step? Boy, my mama taught me when I was six. What the fuck is you talking about? Step in the name of love.
I'm telling you, dog. Step in the name of love. We don't support R. Kelly's actions here, but we do like his music. Yeah.
If he never came up with that song, I would have never known y'all did that shit. Like, I seen Bernie Mac do it back in the early 90s.
You know how many cookouts I was, bro, wearing a fucking tank top and some shorts and some fresh Air Force Ones. My mama told him, I said, boy, that's that shit.
That's what I'm saying. They don't do that shit, but nowhere else. I mean, everybody got their own shit, but.
That's crazy. R. Kelly's made an appearance in two of our episodes now.
Yeah.
As, again, we do not support his actions. You know what I say? Okay, side note.
Let's just say the Pied Piper, which again, that's what I was saying.
That sounds worse, though.
No, that's what I was saying. So this is why.
Peter Pan is not the same as the Pied Piper. For a nigga that's older than us, you don't be knowing shit.
It's so crazy that he went by the Pied Piper in R&B. Because do you know what the Pied Piper did? And he used to play the flute to lure your children away. And this nigga used to literally call himself the Pied Piper, and nobody was catching this shit.
It's a metaphor.
Remember, on the last episode.
No.
What's the metaphor? He was serious.
No, that's why it can't be a metaphor. He's been caught. He was doing the shit.
Jay-Z said, Hove. Meaning,
God.
Of this rap shit, though. Not of the world. That's the metaphor. That's what I'm trying to say. That was hot
I
shit.
I
don't
think Jay-Z's part of the Illuminati. That's neither here nor there. Yeah. Please don't. Illuminati don't come after unless you sponsor us.
Hey, Illuminati, unless you plan on throwing the niggas a boatload of money and a few hundred bitches. Okay. And we'll take an island too, but not on no Jeffrey Epstein shit.
I'll throw up the rock every 5 minutes.
See, that was just an example.
Okay. Hey, as you can see, we are looking for sponsors from anyone, everyone, you know, God, devil, Jesus, whatever. Holler at us, please.
Especially if you're local.
If you're local, give us a sponsorship. You know, Twisters, motherfucking Stripes.
Lotta Burger,
Water Burger.
Golden Pride.
Golden Pride. I'm like, does that shit say we're gonna get a half a rack of ribs, 8 pieces of chicken, some fries, and 3 large sides for $43?
I just seen the menu recently, actually.
It's not like it's bullshit food. The food actually decent. I was like, yo, nigga, I'm like, you know, if there's ever a place I'm gonna tell a nigga to come to, being from Chicago, I'm gonna be like, you need to tell that Golden Pride, player.
That Golden Pride,
but side note, back to the R. Kelly thing, I saw a comment that said 15 years from now, the Trey Songz documentary is going to be way worse than Michael Jackson or R. Kelly because he's truly a degenerate.
They make everybody fucking...
I feel like it's a weird situation with Trey Songz too, though, because like for his, for example, like they said like he sexually intimidates women, and I'm like, how so? That's my thing. It's like, what exactly is he doing? Because they've never said he's like actually like... At least I've never heard him actually being like on these women. Like,
I mean, but you gotta think about it. We don't see behind closed doors and those settings and shit like that.
That's why I want to know more. Like, what exactly?
What is this considered? Can I ask you? What is this considered?
Sexual assault is sexual assault.
Gotcha. But sexual intimidation is this sexual intimidation? If I say, look, bitch. You don't fuck me.
You're not even saying it to me, and I'm intimidated.
So that's what he's doing. He started off with,
look, bitch. You don't fuck me, you're not staying here all night.
Okay, now, when you hear the whole sentence, that's a little different.
This is what I'm trying to say. It's also intimidation, but he's not assaulting.
Does this bitch live with you? Okay,
she's just over.
Also, we're only calling her a bitch because we don't know her imaginary name.
No.
Okay.
Let's say it's bitch Anna.
Who?
Huh?
What? All right. Let's get back on the topic. We've slided off topic a little bit, but to finish this first segment off, what is gang culture to you?
Honestly, man, gang culture is something that it's hard to really put behind you. It'd be best to keep it as positive as you can. Just take the positive aspects of it. But as far as like destructing your community and destructing your brother and shit, I don't think that should be gang culture no more.
You said the destruction of your community and your brother?
Mm-hmm.
Now, for you, AJ, because you are in a fraternity, what is gang culture? Because a lot of people compare.
We just one big ass gang. We mobbing on them campuses. What? We are. I'm not gonna lie to you. Phi Beta Sigma Fraternity Incorporated is not an actual gang. However, the way that fraternities and sororities move on campus, we might as well just be one.
I ain't gonna lie, y'all niggas was moving pretty goddamn deep.
You know what I mean? The way we used to move, like, because when we see, like, say, some Omegas or some Kevins, we ain't gonna start fighting and shit. Niggas ain't finna start poking niggas in the parking lot, you know what I mean? But at the same time,
I didn't use that shit. You said poking niggas. Like, you're acting like this shit is prison.
Nigga, gang culture, nigga. Like, it's not gonna go down like that, but we'll talk shit to each other like, oh, we better than you, this and that, niggas wanna be with us, everybody wanna be down with the Sigmas, bitches love us, whoop-de-whoop, like.
Cause the only thing on that was on our campus at the time was Q's, right?
Yeah, it was just one solo Q.
And nigga, he was one deep-ass nigga by himself.
Hey, cause he wore his shit everywhere, too. Everywhere. It's like, that nigga was like, I gotta put on. It's like, yeah, but
that nigga was over at my gym. This is a small campus, y'all. This nigga's the only Q on this bitch. Ha! Like, doing like.
But low key, that's my dog though. Kayvon Williams, that was my name. We used to all play rugby together. Me, him, and all my fraternity brothers, we all played on the same rugby team. And we, even though we was in different fraternities, we was all still cool as fuck.
I'll be one of your fraternity. I'll be one of your rugby brothers' ass.
Yeah, I'm gonna say, hold on, that nigga's not a part of it.
He be on his own R. Kelly shit. I whooped his ass, by the way.
Just to add on to what you was just saying, a correlation, like a parallel, is
Let's go ahead and add to the list of things Mark is, and he is a relationship coach.
I am.
Concert choir, former Virginia Beach Crip.
Okay.
And he used to be married.
All around entertainer.
It's a lot.
And also,
it's a lot to unpack.
Comedian.
Neither here nor there.
What did you gonna add on?
Yeah. What I was gonna add on is, like you say, you see some talk shit. I think a lot has changed now to where it's not always on site with anybody that's from another gang.
That's a fact.
It's not on site with just anybody.
It's got to be some. Yeah, that's what I'm trying to say. One of my cousins is a blood. We used to just talk shit to each other a lot. That's my cousin at the end of the day. You know what I'm saying? But you know. I heard it.
Somebody's battery is low. When did we charge? It might be.
Oh, okay.
The motherfuckers is charging.
But we didn't need to say that shit on camera. But
I was going to let it ride.
We keep it real around here. Gangsters and Mimosas, goddammit.
We're going to take a brief commercial break, guys. We appreciate y'all for tuning in. See these brief commercials. And little white boy behind this camera, go get that goddamn fucking charger for this shit before it die. Like, what are you doing, man? We ain't gonna say your name on camera. You know, we don't want the brotherhood to know you fuck with us. But we gonna take a break. I know his name because I'm the one who hired him. Doesn't matter. All right, brief commercial break, guys. I will be seeing you soon. Back in the Gangstas and Mimosas podcast, and you know what this next segment is, ladies and gentlemen. It is called Gangsta or Mimosa. If it is gangsta, it is thorough, it is valid. If it's mimosa, it's not necessarily a bad thing, it's just not for you. So, this first thing we're going to talk about in Gangsta or Mimosa is cancel culture, something that's been very, very big in the last few years of everybody's lives. So, that being said, I'm gonna start off with the man on my right
I'm
first.
I'm gonna start with the man at the other end of the table first.
Oh shit, okay.
Let's hear it.
reverse.
Yeah, crisscross! Everybody clap your hands!
Alright, cancel culture. I honestly feel like cancel culture has its place. Cancel culture has its place because, you know, if you're doing some fucked up shit, you shouldn't continue to be able to do that shit. But I also think if they come too late to get you on this shit, that should give you like a, that should knock up.
So basically, it's just like,
they can't catch you in there.
It's like, what is it saying? If they don't catch you, shit. Oh, by the way, just so you know why I'm eating on camera right now, I'm a Muslim, it is Ramadan, and the sun just went down, so your boy is hungry.
Okay, motherfucker, I can only imagine.
So, that being said, like if you get away with a crime or they catch you for a crime, but the crime happened like 7 years ago or some stupid shit. Statute of limitations. There we go. Mm-hmm. There should be a statute of limitations for cancel culture.
Yeah, but also, I feel this as well. Say it again?
Would that be a statute of limitations on culture then? Then eventually you gotta say like some stuff just isn't part of the culture at that point.
But see, okay, so look, I remember being in high school, this is an example. I remember being in high school, and you could still say the F word towards the LGBT. Like, not towards them, yeah, but you could say it, you know, freely. But it wasn't like, you just couldn't say it to, you knew gay people didn't want to be called it.
Yeah.
But if you got mad, that's what you could, you know what I'm saying? Boom. Or you could also just use it in conversation and it wouldn't be towards gay people. But it wasn't like, but that was the 90s, early 2000s, but like the, between like the 2010s and
it's
now.
It's probably out of vernacular for LGBTQ plus community changed over time?
LGBTQIA plus now.
No shit. Okay. Well,
that's correct.
My bad. I'm not in that life. I knew about the plus.
Like we said, episode one, we love everybody, but we'll never be politically correct.
Right. And you know what's crazy is, they say it's just like the N-word. You wouldn't say that to...
Oh, the hell it is.
But you, they let you say the N-word, whether it's with the ER, whether it's with the A, on social media. But they don't let you say the F-word at all. That's why I spell it different. I spell it Figot. So...
You know, I don't even say it. You just spell it
different. Yeah, hell yeah. I just say it so I won't get in Facebook jail.
Guess I can drop one to G.
Like, acting like a Figot. A piglet.
Wow.
Hey, okay, this is a side note. The piglet shit is only funny to me because that shit was funny as hell. But my auntie is like, she's black, but she like country black. So you was a nigga. If it was a female next to you, she's a niggette. And then if it was a kid, it was a nigglet. And I was just like, oh yeah. And if all because niggas kept stepping on her grass, she would get so upset about that shit. Get these little nigglets off my mother. She was the female Uncle Ruckus before Uncle Ruckus became a thing.
That's wild. Shout out to female Uncle Ruckus for real.
Hope she's still around.
Auntie Francine, holla at me.
Sounds like she is.
Francine's a crazy name, right?
I mean, not really, if you think about it from that time. That's part of the culture. You know, back then, like, I got so many Ernest's and all that shit, like...
There's still Ernest's in this day and age. There ain't a lot of Francine's walking around.
Who was child Ernest?
You be surprised.
Nah.
I know Ernest Jr. and we are the same age.
Okay, that was when we was born, in the 90s.
So I know a little Ernest, too.
Wow.
So anyway, guys... Do y'all think this fucking cancel culture should go by culture? Statute of limitations. The example I use is because that shit was cool back then. Just because it's not cool now, how the fuck you gonna punish me for what the law is now? That wasn't the law back then. Is that the
case? Okay, now hold on now. That's when it comes into play. That can be a white person. It was cool calling niggas back then. Like, come on now.
It was also cool to hang niggas. That was
I'm
legal
gonna
back
keep talking so the crowd doesn't take this out of context of what you just said.
The point what I'm trying to say is that shit was
cool
legal.
To hang niggas back then.
Yeah, it was.
I was going to make a TikTok edit of just that part in your face.
That's cool. Do it. Because my thing is, that shit was legal back then.
Jerry Jones was hanging niggas.
But that shit ain't legal now.
That's right. He is in that shit.
But see, my thing is, what we said is freedom of speech. It was legal. We could say that shit back then. Oh, there was stuff that you could do that back then. But if it's looked at as predatory or raping now or racism now, you gonna get me on some shit that used to be the common norm? Like, if that's the case, we gotta get all the fucking slave masters and the descendants of slave masters who were still in the house, because that's still fucking accessory to
2023. This nigga act like there is some super serum for slave masters that's still around.
Nigga, Ruby Bridges is only fucking 50 years old. Black girl to be integrated in America in a integrated school. She's like in her 50s, maybe 60s. But here's what I'm trying to say: the South is different than all over.
This is the
thing. Keep in mind, Emmett Till came from Chicago.
Let's talk about Kansas culture though, because now we're gonna go on a tangent about Black history, and we did that last episode.
We did. You missed it.
Okay, but see, no, I'm just saying. I'm just using it as a parallel, my nigga, because it has to have a statute of
the cholesterol got me, y'all.
I got high blood pressure. It's not cholesterol. My levels are pretty good. Okay, my A1C is like a 6-ish. And then anyway, I walk on the treadmill every day. But anyway, carry on. Back to what I was saying. Fuck you, man.
Treadmill every day.
Yeah, you know what's crazy?
That nigga be on the treadmill like this. 41, 42, 43, 45, 46, 47.
That's the range, my friend. Neither here nor there. But see, the thing about it is, bro, I'm telling you, man, if you gonna judge me on some shit I did in the 80s or the 70s, you can't do that type of shit, man. That's what I don't like about cancel culture. And then also what I don't like about cancel culture is the flip side. The other thing I don't like about cancel culture is Yo, if that shit ain't true, you say some shit about me, you cancel me, and you find out that shit ain't true, you should be able to erase all that shit. Don't still have your stigma in my mind that every time somebody hear me, that every time you hear Usher, oh, that nigga got herpes, that nigga burning. It won't true. But once you get the negative shit in your head, the culture nowadays, they don't know how to fucking, okay, everything was innocent. Nah, he did that shit.
I'm gonna edit this shit in post, and it's gonna, like, the sound of it's gonna go off, and it's gonna play like this. Dum, 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 dum. And it's just gonna say Mark rants for 5 minutes.
Hey, I'll take my segments when I can. I'm one more mic time, I'll take it. What y'all think about that, though, dog? False cancel.
You seem like you're on the opposite, so I wanna hear it.
Cancel culture is gangsta as fuck, bro.
Okay.
The fact that you.
Okay. Yeah, that's what I like to hear.
It's literally what people not seeing. Like, if you telling me that a group of people can one day just say, drop this nigga from everything, and he gets dropped from everything?
Everything.
Nigga, that's pretty thug.
A fucking 12-year-old on Twitter can ruin a nigga's life that's a billionaire.
That's all it takes is one person being like, we need to cancel this person, and all their followers just agree. Cancel culture is pretty gangsta. Do I agree with it all the time? No, but this is some gangster ass shit. Like when Dave Chappelle made them transgender jokes, they tried their hardest. That's the one nigga I've seen who couldn't get canceled.
He's the only nigga I've seen escape it.
Yeah, because when Kevin Hart made them, what did Kevin Hart say? He said some shit about gay people, right?
He said that shit 7 years prior.
Exactly, and he was getting canceled for saying that.
He couldn't even host the Oscars.
Yeah, I was worried if this nigga was actually gonna get a chance to even do stand up again. Like they was gonna be like, nah, ain't nobody buying your tickets. Like it was about to get ugly.
To the point, I hear comedians, like, I watched Ali Sadiq's The Domino Effect. Hilarious stand-up, y'all should go check it out.
Funny-ass dude.
Yeah, fun. Very funny-ass dude. And it was one segment, he was talking about somebody from the 80s that's in the, what is it called again?
The LGBTQIA plus?
Plus.
Bang, bang. All right, and he said, back then we called them sissies. Ain't nobody. He said, and I quote, he's
that's
like,
hilarious, man. That's hilarious. The best time you heard sissy, bro.
Hey, look, and I was laughing hard. He said, back sissy. Then we called them sissies. But he's like, but remember, this was the 80s. Don't write no fucking letter on me. And the fact that he has to add that into the stand up, even though it's a joke and we're laughing at it, he's actually doing that for a valid reason.
Dude, if Bernie Mac didn't do...
Ooh, he would make it in today's culture, dog.
Kings of Comedy about the milk and cookies. That's the... Nigga, that was like the closing joke. But one of the closing jokes, like, yo...
There's a milk and cookies.
You know what I'm saying? If he didn't say, you know, the F word over and over again, you know what I'm saying? That was funny as hell, bro. But...
I agree, yeah, the shit was funny, but still, cancel culture is just a thugged out shit. Like, the minute you say you have the power to just get a nigga dropped from everything, that's pretty gangster. That's like, that's next level shit.
And see, I honestly think we should transition to the next joint, bro, because it ties in to social media shit.
Oh, yeah, for sure. Okay,
because the thing about it is, though.
No, we gotta answer the question, though.
Okay.
He said cancel culture is gangster. Do you feel it's mimosa? Or is it gangsta?
Well, for the reason why he said, I can understand why you say that, I'm going to say mimosa just because it really marginalizes and really kind of minimizes creativity.
Oh, I can see that.
You know what I'm saying?
But you don't believe there's people that do truly deserve to get canceled?
No, I do. I'm just talking about as far as the part where you cancel somebody for something they said in the past. Said in the past.
Okay.
Now, during the past is two different things.
Yeah,
you know what I'm saying? You don't get the same time for a threat that you do for murder, my nigga, or whatever. You know what I'm saying? So, you know, I'm gonna say, oh, okay, my answer all in all, I say mimosa.
Okay, so I'm gonna play devil's advocate and say it's a little bit of both. There's times where that shit is gangster as fuck, and then there's times where that shit is kind of mimosa. When people was trying to cancel Dave Chappelle, that shit was mimosa. He is a fucking comedian. He's there to literally tell jokes. And 9 times out of 10, most of the shit comedians say, even if they say, oh, this is a real life story, it's a real life story with a lot of fictional shit added to it. It might be real life to them. This is their view of the story.
Okay,
using that music degree, ain't he? And they
embellished.
You know, okay, they hit a lot of extra embellishment, you know, putting a little stank on it. And that being said, we transition to the next thing. Social media. Is it Gangsta or Mimosa? He went first, I wanna hear you.
Right now, I think social media is very Mimosa. Everybody's sensitive on there.
So at what point was it Gangsta?
MySpace.
Come on now, dog. That's basically when it started.
That's when the shit was Gangsta, though. Like MySpace.
That top six, nigga?
What? MySpace was when. Look, this is why I was so
mad. No, MySpace, Black Planet, baby.
Yeah, true. But like, look, because you got things, you put your top five, top eight, whatever. Nigga, when you really, somebody, you wasn't fucking with nobody, how they find out? That nigga took me out of his top five. I thought it was cool. That shit was like cutting niggas off in silence. He was really moving different with MySpace.
But that was the, that was actually the start of it. Because you could talk shit to a motherfucker on MySpace, but when you see him.
We're not gonna bypass the fact that you got your phone on. And I saw your punk ass look at your shit too, nigga. I just want to let it be known.
I don't know why you're talking about shit. Like, you can just stuff your face on camera.
Hey, nigga, I'm a Muslim, nigga. I was Muslim, bro. Hey, what's up, my boy? Like,
Ramadan.
I've been saying Ramadan. I'm gonna get one of y'all to say that shit on just record, and I'm gonna drop that shit in as I'm eating. And I'm like, Ramadan! But nah, to me, social media is definitely. I'm not gonna. Nah, I don't know. That shit low key kind of gangsta still, dog. The amount of shit I can do on social, I see the news, I can see sports, I can see some booty in that bitch. I can help find a missing child. I can find.
And it never runs out.
Never runs out. That's the best part.
Just fall asleep.
Just like, it's like TV all over again. You might see the same thing twice, but you gonna see something new for sure on that next channel. Like, that shit might still be kind of gangster, dog. But it is ruining lives. I'm not gonna lie. And the reason why I say that shit is gangster, because there's a whole lot of niggas in the world right now getting pussy that they would have never got no pussy without social media right now. They
41 for 2
67. Hey, look, there's a lot of niggas that's faking the funk, and females that's faking the funk, living a false narrative, got people really over here ready to kill themselves because their life ain't as good as yours, hypothetically. So
that bitch bathed with two little small ass pieces of
stuff. Exactly, she taking them two pieces of dub. And that nigga, is wearing the holy draws for the third time this week. And you motherfuckers will literally sit here and, oh, well, he took a picture in front of Ferrari. That don't mean it's his shit. You don't even know if this picture edited. That might not even be him in the actual scene.
You ever see me in front of a nice ass sports car and I'm not behind the wheel taking off? It's not
me.
It's not
me.
It's
not me.
That's it. It's just not
me. It's not me, player.
Never let them take that picture.
So it's like, I think it's really, the reason why I'm saying it's gangster, because it's like, I've always found con man very gangster. The fact that you can go in there and con a nigga out of everything. These con men and of the 50s to the 90s was really some brilliant ass motherfuckers. And to me, in my head, the people who created social media, they're con men. Think about all the people who've ever created social media. They're not extroverts at all. They're introverts.
I think that's why it's still so Mimosa. You gotta fake the funk on social media.
Oh no, you got it. But see, there's a thing though. There's people who fake the funk, and then there's niggas who's living that life for real, and they gonna floss on you every chance they get.
What's his name? Dan Bilzerian or some shit.
Dan Bilzerian.
Shout out to that nigga. If you wanna sponsor us,
holler at us. Dan Bilzerian, the Nilk Boys, whatever y'all call yourselves. Unfortunately, Adam 22, we heard you a pedophile. Don't talk to us, nigga. There's a lot of allegations coming out.
Can we talk about this real quick?
What?
Put a pause right there in the Adam 22 thing. What if it comes out that Adam 22 is not a pedophile? We're still gonna be calling him a fucking pig. He can't hear that, man.
Cancel that nigga. That shit against him. His life is over, nigga.
Just cancel that.
Hey, but you gotta think about it. He's still married to a porn star and shit like that. He good.
Yeah.
She bad as hell, too. She wanted to call this in the game.
What, he said his wife?
Yeah.
I think he's seen her on a couple porn hubs.
The porn hubs.
They had the porn stars come in. I said, damn, man.
What the fuck is her name? I don't remember, but I know she bad as a motherfucker.
Yeah.
Can I have a quick question?
Yeah.
So I was told on the last episode there was a woman with a really big ass here.
He's talking
and
about
the fact that I wasn't here.
Oh, no, no, you were here and you had a personal emergency. Oh, no, AJ, come on.
Well, I'm not gonna do this. I'm not gonna air quotes.
Come on, do it with me. One time.
He had a personal emergency.
That's what I had.
Allegedly.
It was in parentheses, not quotations. But the thing about it is, man, neither here nor there. But the question I'm asking is,
this nigga left. He left, said, I'm gonna go outside and check on my car real quick. Mind you, we don't know why he always checking on his car. Well, if we do, somebody stole his last car, so he's paranoid, which we all understand. But that being said,
don't come to Albuquerque.
Don't come to Albuquerque.
That's what the fucking AAA man said. I said, nigga, get the fuck out of here, man.
But that being said, ladies and gentlemen, the man goes outside to check on the car, and like that daddy went to go get that milk, he never came back. Didn't text us, didn't call us, didn't respond to any of our text and calls, and then hit us back up the next day like ain't shit happened.
It seemed like the daddy that didn't. I wanted to come back, it's just, you know, gotta get some things off my mind.
That's why. Still, though, social media is very mimosa.
I think it's still gangster. Mark?
I would say gangster.
Oh, 2-1 for the first time on the show. AJ has taken a L, baby.
It's not really an L. I mean, it's
that shit is like,
niggas are sensitive on social media, and you see it.
But, you know, the niggas are sensitive
on social media. Niggas fake their life on social media. And
but
you
also,
it.
Again, the niggas that are sensitive on social media, those are niggas that are sensitive in real life as well.
Okay.
But, okay.
So, the niggas fake their life as well.
Yeah, there's niggas faking their lives. There's niggas that are actually living that life and having a good time. And then there's niggas that just take social media, like me, for what it is. It's a game. You just there to have fun and look at shit.
All around, we can say that it's entertaining. For the niggas that's faking their shit, they're entertaining you. That's not my fucking real life. It provides entertainment all day, whether it's sports, news, comedy, entertainment.
Again, social media was most of social media sites were made by introverts because they themselves faked the funk. They want to be extroverts, and this was the only way they knew how to do it. Does Mark? Mark
does not.
No, it does not. Mark Zuckerberg is worth $8 billion. I'm good.
You can't talk to a bitch in person? Sucks.
He has a wife. He's not supposed to.
You don't need to with $8 billion, man.
Bill Gates had a wife too.
Hey, and Bill Gates.
So is Jeff Bezos.
It's Bezos. And,
Is what?
It's Bezos.
Jeff Bezos.
Why are you not a real Mexican for this? Bezos?
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 it's Bezos. And, Bezos. Like I was saying, he, unlike all the other social media motherfuckers, he be living that life. He be having fun. I ain't gonna lie.
As he should.
I'll be seeing Mark Zuckerberg in court. I don't never see Jeff Bezos in court.
If you naming all these billionaires, and we already knew billionaires were living a great life. We knew millionaires were living a great life.
And there's niggas that's 100,000 years, $10 years.
But the number of niggas faking it to the number of niggas doing it makes a mimosa.
Hey, look, I know a crackhead right now. His name is Earl. He's a $10 heir, and I can promise you he has social media because I follow him, and I'll pull his shit up, and he is the funnest nigga on the planet. He's living his life.
I mean, yeah, he don't got shit else to do.
You don't know what that man got to do.
He gotta figure out a way to get some shelter.
I said he was a crackhead. I didn't say he was homeless.
Damn, well, you're right.
Okay. Right. When did I say he was homeless? I said he was a crackhead.
I'm back and soon. He was on the
Earl podcast.
Hey, Earl. I know you don't
actually,
really.
Maybe not. That nigga before we come in here and start stealing.
Hey, no. We're not definitely not doing it here. Hey, Earl, brother, we would love to have you on the podcast, my man. Whenever you do check this episode out, remember, you can reach him at @IMJustAJ_. You can reach this motherfucker.
My username tonight.
@AY_Mark, and then you can reach me at Teddy Bear Shane. We're not gonna give you the business handle because that's not your business. But Earl, holler at us, baby. We can do the interview at a hotel or some shit.
Holler at us, Earl. We only smoke weed though.
And yeah, we don't do that other shit.
I'm gonna smoke it. Oh yeah, I wrote this in the car. Nah.
Hey, nigga, hey, you know some shit off with a blunt be a little too chunky. Motherfucker be like, hey, y'all wanna hit this? No, I'm good, player.
That bitch be
thick. Don't you, hey, when a motherfucker hit and don't let it be a pin, you can see the resin, you be holding that shit up to the light, like, what's that sparkly shit up in there? I don't.
That shit don't look right.
And that shit look funny. But guys, you know what's coming up next. And we're gonna have to take a brief commercial break because somebody here at the table let me know today they got some shit to get off their chest. And next up is Ski Mask Talk, and we talking about what we wanna leave in 2023, whether it's personal to me or you or the world, we gonna talk about it. Holla at your boy.
Sir.
Yeah. Y'all know how this shit go.
You know.
All eyes on me.
Buffalo G. Roll up in the club.
That right. All eyes on me. All eyes on me.
You know what?
I bet you got it twisted, you don't know who to trust. So many player-hating niggas trying to sound like us. Say they ready for the funk, but I don't think they know it. Straight to the depths of hell is where them cowards going. Well, all you steal down, nigga, holler when you see me. And let these devils be sorry for the day they finally freed me. I got a caravan of niggas every time we ride. Hitting motherfuckers up when we pass by. Until I die, live the life of a boss player. Cause even when I'm high, fuck with me.
And thank you for tuning back in to Gangstas, Mimosas podcast. This is the last segment of the day, and we really love having y'all here for Ski Mask Talk. And we have the lovely
Asha.
Speak into the microphone, ho, please.
Asha. My name is Asha.
Okay.
Man, listen.
Now, that being said, I am glad to have all of you lovely fans here. We know that you love us and we love you. You also love the white boy behind the camera, but we ain't talking about him. He don't have a name. Fuck you. Alright? Now, that being said, we love what we do, but here and today and now, we are going to talk about Ski Mask Talk, which is today.
We need to be the 2023.
Everything has been trying to wait that to nigga today. Today we talking about what we need to leave in fucking 2023, y'all. So, what is something you want to leave in 2023? I'm gonna go ahead and get the nigga that likes to ramble the most out the way.
And you're talking about me, AF47. What I'm gonna leave?
Supposed to say 41, 42, 43, 45, 46, 40.
7. Are you skipping a number?
Am I?
I feel like you skipped a number when you
probably did, but
I'm not saying,
what am I leaving in 2023? Oh man,
it's only March. I'm just saying in general, like something that maybe carried over the last 3 years and it's also still being done in 2023, but we need to dead that shit this year. And since the cholesterol got this nigga brain slowing down, let me go ahead and slide over to this nigga, AJ.
Man, what I bet. What we need to leave in 2023? I think we need to leave, like, this whole political, like, beef bullshit on Facebook, it just needs to be.
I different. Like that.
Like, I feel like this shit is pointless at this point. Like, we get it. You want to be a Republican. Cool.
Exactly. Your cool. Family owns slaves and you wish they was back. It's okay.
We don't need to keep talking about this shit. I get it. That's where you stand. That's where I stand. Regardless, at least we still standing. You feel? Like, you know what I mean? Like, I'm just kind of over that shit already. Like,
I'm fucking with that.
Bro, the election happened in 2020. It's 2023. We about to have another one and start the same fucking cycle over.
That is a fact, and it's gonna be the same bullshit, the same some redneck motherfucker calling your little cousin Dada a nigga in his comments because he did a TikTok dance.
So why are we talking about politics on social media? It needs to be done. We can end it in 2023. This is the year.
Yeah. Mark, how do you feel about that?
I mean, yeah, I think. I can't really talk about the motherfucking political beef because I'm not into politics. But as far as the childish bullshit, it's any type of beef on fucking social media. Just come on. Unless that shit is marketable.
I just want this.
You know what? He's making a good point. Some political beefs are marketable
like what?
On social media.
Okay, it's marketable. That's great. I don't want to hear this shit no more, though.
Okay, so if you was running for office and you knew that's what you needed to do to
win. Bro, once I'm done running for office, stop talking about me.
It's over. I won or I lost. Either way, we here now. Shut the fuck up. Like, it's not my fault that nigga got more votes than me.
And how about you, sweetie? What are you thinking?
I'm not in the politics either, shit. But...
Yeah, what's so crazy is I feel like everybody thinks about leaving politics. It's literally just what you mean to leave in 2023, though.
No, I'm asking about politics.
What the old-ass niggas got going on?
Oh, my goodness, so you can leave it in 2023.
But
so I left in 2023.
I left a long time. What am I leaving in 2023?
What are you leaving in 2023, Mark? We gave you enough time.
Okay, cool. I'm going to leave. It's high blood pressure. Actually, my cholesterol level is
going
to
low poorly.
My A1C is actually of like a 6 or something like that. But
I don't even know what A1C is.
You're the nurse, tell them. I mean, I just know I don't have fucking diabetes. So,
how are you with cholesterol and diabetes?
He's trying to start a jab. This nigga, I think he got a voodoo doll and he keep poking cholesterol in there, but no. Because he keeps saying I got high cholesterol. And I don't, guys. That's blood pressure. But what about leaving in 2023? I think I'll feel the weight.
I'm getting tired of this, bro. Like, this nigga's right with me now. Fuck it, take a shot, bro. Come on, what's up? Say something. Tell me, what you leaving in 2023?
Well, what I won't be leaving is a perfect smile. You can't say
the same.
And two eyes that focus. And you can't say the same.
You can't even look at the camera right now, my boy. Who are you talking about?
This nigga has a nice haircut with a little head.
I wanted to say something.
Yo.
For y'all get to roasting each other. I wouldn't say I'm leaving it, but I want to be more intentional this year. If I say I'm going to do something, I need to do it.
So procrastination.
Yes.
That's what you're leaving.
Yes.
Okay.
Yes. So we'll leave the procrastination. Okay. So be more intentional this year.
So you got a personal. What's something in everyday life outside of your own personal that you would prefer to be left by everybody?
I would want everybody to be more intentional.
Like, okay, everybody then. Everybody
be
more intentional.
A lot of people are very not.
All right, a lot of people are very not. So, hey, sir, if you are intentionally cheating on your bitch, make sure you keep on doing it. You pile drive them hoes, all right?
Be intentional, babe.
That's
be intentional, babe. If you out here sucking other niggas' dicks, make sure you get that nigga the sloppiest top, then go home and kiss your boyfriend.
Just to ask a question about what you just said, the whole in its totality. So, you said intentional.
Mm-hmm.
So, is that in all aspects?
Oh, yes.
You want to just, you would rather people deal more direct or with their tongue? Okay.
Yeah, why?
All right, because they was going on the sex thing, and I was like, is that, that's where you at with it nowadays?
No, it's
just
like
directly. What it is, nigga, is we doing it and all. Is it that?
Everything. Look, everything. Life is too short. If there's something that you want, say that. I don't know, if there's something you need, go get that shit.
I like intention.
Be more intention.
Which I know what they say, intentions without application is null and void.
Isn't there a quote in my life?
Did they say that in the book?
Mark, are you going to actually say something of intention?
No, I'm not. I just wanted to be clear on my own. You know, we just say intentions. Cause look, bro.
Okay, Moesha's auntie is not. She don't have nothing to leave in 2023. That's unfortunate. Hey, now remember.
Right,
Dad. Things I want to leave in 2023. My own personal shit. I want to leave motherfuckers behind. Everybody I don't fuck with. Family members. Friends. Niggas, bitches, dogs, cats, whatever. If I don't fuck with you, stop talking to me.
Circle K cashiers.
I don't go to Circle K, nigga. We go to Murphy's Express, nigga. We go to Murphy's.
You go to Murphy's.
Sir, you go to Circle K?
What's the purpose?
Circle K is for the alcoholics, okay?
Well, I mean,
I go to Circle K.
Circle K is for the alcoholics. Alright, I want to leave anybody who does not add value to my life the fuck alone. Because I promise you, I'm trying my best to be on to bigger and better things every moment of my day. And if you're not adding to my life, you gotta get the fuck out of my life. Now, in everyday life, I want to end all the front. Be you, dog. I'm so sick of, oh, niggas over the last 10 years have been fronting for just about everything. You front for the gram. You front for fucking Facebook. You front for Twitter. You front for TikTok now. And you front for your bitch ass baby mama. Fuck that bitch. If you ain't got no money on child support this much, let that hoe know. It's okay. They took all your money last month. You gotta pay rent this month or they gonna kick you the fuck out. It's okay. Let them niggas know. Have some fun. Enjoy your goddamn life. Stop fronting for these bitch ass niggas who don't own Lamborghinis. That shit is rented off of Toro. They paid $2,000 for it when they could have just bought some stock. Like,
for a day. Rented for the day.
Now that's how you do a rant. Okay? That's how you do a rant. Because somebody over here had zilch to say
so
all goddamn
shit.
You
need people that are intentional in your life.
You're right. I need people with good intentions, bad intentions, but as long as I know your intentions from the very beginning, I'm okay with it.
That part.
AJ?
Brought it full circle. Intentions.
Intentions.
Probably all just
hold on,
gonna
hold on.
Say
hey, look, a friendly reminder for the white boy, make sure you throw that.
Intentions.
What are you talking about? Did we just say
you
intentions?
Like,
these are your, my intentions.
You know, like, that's
I got it. Alright, people. I love y'all to death. Thank you for tuning in to Gangstas and Mimosas podcast. I'm going to go around the table so that everybody can let you know what they got going on in life and also let you know where you can follow them at. Who's up? Mr. Mark J himself.
Y'all already know what it is. I'm glad I can sit up straight now and not hunch back. But you can catch me on all social media, @AY_MarkJ. But y'all also know me as AF47. And what that means is I'm the auntie fucker. 41, 42, 43, 44, 45, 46, 47. That's some ranges I fucking man. Neither here nor there.
The next man will be Mr. AJ Matthews himself.
Yeah, so you already know where you can follow me. I'm just AJ _ on all social media. Check me out everywhere, all over Albuquerque doing comedy.
He does comedy everywhere, big and small, and the lady who might be big or small, you can't tell on this camera because that white boy did his job. Now.
You can follow my Insta, I love a girl, and my Snap is mommy 3 times.
You gotta spell it out for him.
MAMIII_X3.
And you can make sure to follow your own Smokeface the Visionary at Teddy Bear Shane on Instagram and Twitter. You can also follow our business page, Black Mafia Productions. And you can also hit the website, blackmafiaproductions.com, baby, and go buy some tickets to King of the Fucking Rings. Okay? And you're gonna be getting a chance to watch this nigga sit in the stands and this nigga perform on the stage. Have a good night, ladies and gentlemen.